This is Channel 9 Eyewitness News at 6. Coverage you can count on.
It's our major story tonight. A boy accused of recording under the skirts of fellow students still goes to the same high school with them.
They should be able to feel safe, but sadly, the reality is they feel far from safe.
Now 9 investigates the district's plan to protect the victims and why their parents say it doesn't go far enough. Police believe the alleged crimes happened inside the classroom. Good evening, I'm Martha Sagowski.
And I'm Greg Wormuth. We've had two reporters investigating this story for months. And if you were watching Eyewitness News at 5, you heard Channel 9's Shannon Butler tell one victim's story. And now at 6, Channel 9's Janine Reyes has been looking into the school district safety plan. And Janine, it's an agreement that parents say is not protecting their girls.
And Greg, these parents have been very involved. They've been emailing the school's principal. They've reached out to the school district's administration. They've even gone so far as to hire an attorney to help protect their girls. They tell us tonight that's still not happening, and the school district and administration are not commenting.
They're absolutely treating me as if I'm the criminal and the other victims as well.
We're not identifying the 16-year-old girl who at the age of 15 reported a male student at Winter Park High School shooting video up her skirt. The girl's attorney tells us police ultimately took that boy's cell phone, finding images identifying even more victims on campus. Two sets of parents sat down to speak with us. Their identity also kept private so that we do not identify their daughters. The girl's parents say since coming forward, fellow students have shown support for the suspect who happens to be a football player on the school's undefeated team. The girls now are feeling the pushback.
These girls did nothing wrong. They went to class, and this guy violated their privacy.
The district cannot tell what punishment they had in place for the boy because they have to protect his privacy. The girl's parents provided a safety plan for one victim and two different supervision plans for the boy. The most recent, a 10-point plan that requires a parent or guardian to escort him to the main office because he and the victims had seen each other in the school parking lot despite rules requiring no contact with the victims. The plan shows he's got his own separate bell schedule so he won't see the girls in the hall. But pictures snapped by the victims show that's not happening.
My daughter feels very uncomfortable.
Point number 4 on the plan says if the boy has a cell phone, he will turn it into the front desk before the start of school each day. And a parent, guardian, or coach will be with the boy from the beginning of practice until the time he leaves campus. He also has to eat lunch on the benches between the 300 and 400 building with an administrator. The parents tell us some rules are being followed, but not all of them. And their girls feel punished, not protected.
The no contact contracts are not worth the paper that they're written on. The supervision plan that is supposed to govern the offender, this young man, is not worth the paper it's written on. It's a joke.
And those parents have emailed the principal constantly about what they feel are violations of those agreements. The school keeps telling them that those encounters are accidental. They've also reached out to school board chairman Bill Sublette. We reached out to him as well today. He did not respond. Greg, Martha.
You know, Janine, you shared that 10-point plan that seems very detailed. So why are the parents not satisfied with at least that?
Well, part of the problem, Greg, is one of those requirements is for the suspect to turn in his cell phone if he brings it with him to school. The parents say they've asked if someone can verify by checking his belongings that he does not have a cell phone on him. That is not being done, and that's part of the problem they have with the plan that's outlined on these papers. Back to you.
All right, Janine, thank you. And we have new information.